खड़े होने वाले।
फाइकस रिलीजियोसा ऑल्सो नोन एज पीपल ट्री इन इंडिया। दिस फाइकस कटिंग वॉज इट्स अराउंड 5 months ओल्ड एंड इट्स प्लेस इन टू स्मॉल कैविटी ऑन अ पीस ऑफ डेड वुड एंड इट्स रूट्स आर फ्लोइंग इन टू दिस पॉट फुल ऑफ वाटर। सो इट इज अ हाइड्रोपोनिक सेटअप, वेरी फ्यू रूट्स इन सॉइल, मोस्टली इन वाटर। आई विल एक्सप्लेन दिस सेटअप इन डिटेल एंड देन टेल यू हाउ आई रीच हियर सो दैट यू टू कैन गेट सिमिलर रिजल्ट्स। The original thickness of this cutting was something like this, the way this current branch looks. So in the last 5 months, this thickness has almost increased to more than double. And this is all happening because, not because of the soil on this cavity, but due to the water roots. A massive amount of roots are there in the water, I'll show you later. This is a grass that grew by itself over here. I didn't remove it because grass has shallow roots and they help in quickly gripping things together. So whatever moss and whatever little soil was placed there, even before the ficus roots could establish, I think the grass roots would establish and hold everything together. So it's a good idea. Yes, it will take up some of your nutrition, but no big deal. Just make sure one or two strands are there. Allow the roots to spread. You can remove it later. In fact, I'm going to remove it right now. When I took the cutting first, it was just a straight piece. This branching did not exist. So due to repeated pinching, I encouraged this side branch development, and that is how I have reached till here. And it will be further refined, so this has to split into two. Same way here also, this also has to split into two. Actually, the splitting has happened here further away from the main branch. I might have to trim it back a little lower, but that's going to be done later. So this is where the cavity is actually. This whole thing is a big cavity, and there's a little bit of soil kept there onto which the roots were placed, and whatever had to fit on this side was trimmed away, but the longer roots were allowed to escape from this side into soil initially, but now it is water. I'll explain that later. I'm going to remove this thermocol so that my exposure readings are not going haywire. Check these roots out. This is amazing. I am also seeing these roots after a long gap, and the last time I saw they weren't this awesome. This is amazing. Because all this while I kept it covered with thermocol, I never bothered to lift it. As the water level decreased, I used to just refill it with a squeeze bottle. So it's been a long while since I actually saw what's inside. The top section of this whole setup is a self-watered system. I am not watering this manually. Very rarely do I do it. Only when I see that the moss is not wet enough, I sprinkle a little bit of water on top. But most of the time, the entire watering system is done through these twines which have been fixed here. So these twines, these cotton twines, are sandwiched between the thin layer of soil and the moss. And this was set up when this pot soil was replaced with water. So that time I needed this because I knew I could not water this myself. This self-watering system is very useful as far as keeping this moss green, because now the weather is hot and there is no way I could have manually kept this green. Now let me show you the back. There are more threads over here. So this is another thread hanging in water here, and there's one more here. Yeah. So when this was set up, the season was monsoon. It was humid and cloudy, and I didn't need so many twines hanging into water because that would supply excess water. So at that time I would slowly lift one of these and take it off water. So this way I am able to regulate how much water reaches the top. So treat them as tentacles dipping into water. If the weather is hot, push all these tentacles back into water. If it's a humid season, rainy season, you don't need so many tentacles, lift them out. Maybe one is enough. And if you feel there is a dry patch, then again you can push it back. So this is how I regulate the water supply to the top. It's very simple. Instead of using a thick piece of cloth, twine works better. Multiple twines, and you can individually control how much you want. It's a fun system, try it out. This pot is completely filled with roots. I do not recommend earthen pot for this system. Now I'm realizing the drawback of it, because this pot is basically disintegrating. When I touch the wet patches, the earthen pot is coming apart. Also, once the roots reach the top, the edge, now what happens is they're drawing water up, and as the roots extend out, the water also starts dripping down. So it's constantly leaking out like this because of the root action. So either I have to prune the roots and keep it inside completely, but I've just wanted to show you the wild growth of the roots. So this, because of the root action drawing water outside, I have to constantly keep this filled in. And it's of late it's become a bit nuisance. I have to replace this with a plastic container. This has to go. That means all these roots have to be disturbed too. So I'm not sure if I'll do it in this video. Let's see. When the moss was first placed on the loose soil, it was tough to make it sit over there. It wasn't gripping the surface. And to keep it locked in place, I tied the whole setup with crisscrossing twines. And once this thing I felt was established enough, I removed and cut all of those. So those twines were different from the tentacle ones that were designed to hang into the water. For the last 2 months, the roots of this ficus have been in water. And prior to that, it was in soil for 1.5 months in the same pot. So this thermocol's purpose was, one is to prevent mosquitoes from laying eggs into this setup. And the primary function, of course, is to block light. Because if the light is not blocked, you will have green algae growth inside this. It sticks on the wall container, it sticks on the roots, and makes the whole water turn green. So when I want to shoot video, I don't get such beautiful views. So that is the primary purpose of these thermocol pieces. You got to block the light. This cutting was initially rooted in water like this, and I normally trim the roots as soon as they reach the inner walls of the glass. But for this case, I didn't prune the roots, and they were allowed to grow long and into circling roots. This is another rooted cutting of a different ficus. So this is how the roots look when they are not pruned. So density is not that great, but I get long roots. Now I can use this to wrap it around a rock or something
any kind of setup. So it basically gives me a lot of flexibility in planning. And in the, if later I don't want such long routes, I can always cut it. So I have cuttings of both the varieties, pruned and unpruned. So after a month of rooting, keeping it in water, I had good, reasonably long roots, and those were placed into this cavity, and some of them are allowed to dip into soil. And so initially the setup was on soil, not in water, because the reason for that was the transition was mainly the roots are dipping from this side. Now this is sitting above water, or it's sitting on the neck of the pot. So I needed a gradual slope of soil covering that entire root mass. So once the roots are long enough to go in, that's when I decided soil can come out and I switched to water. This deadwood is not permanently fixed on it, it's just loosely resting on these pot edges. So I'll show you, I'll lift it. Wow. It's pulling the entire root system. Wow. Awesome. So that is the whole system. Can you see that? Amazing. I myself haven't seen roots like this. This is crazy, 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 crazy. I'm also seeing this for the first time. I haven't lifted this out of the pot for a long time, and it wasn't this dense last time. This is like a complete network of roots. Oh wow, it's beauty. Now this wood is not treated with lime sulfur, and it is wet from the top as well as bottom. The bottom touches water, which can lead to a situation where the wood starts rotting, but this is extremely tough wood. So I'm hoping there is no major damage, and in my next potting I hope to give some more gap so it is not actually touching the water from below, but the top will be wet anyway. But I guess that's okay.